When you multiply by a whole number, you may have noticed that the answer is greater than the number you started with. That is always true when you multiply by a whole number. But when you multiply by a fraction, this is not always true. In this lesson, you'll learn why that is. Let's look first at an illustration of multiplying by a whole number. Here we multiply 4 by 3. The answer is 12, which is represented by all the blocks in the array. 12 is greater than 4, so the answer was greater than the number you started with. Now let's see what happens when we multiply 4 by a fraction. We still have 4 as our starting number. But we'll change the number we multiply by to 3 1/2. Like this. Now, let's divide each column into halves, like this. We can now represent the array as 7 halves. And our multiplication problem becomes 4 times 7 halves. We know that when we multiply, the answer is 28 halves. We can rewrite this as the whole number 14. You can see that the answer, 14, is greater than 4. So multiplying 4 by a fraction gives us a number that is greater than 4. Now let's look at a different situation. Let's change the number we multiply by from 7/2 to 1/2, like this. We now have 4 times 1/2. The answer is 4/2, which is equal to 2. 2 is less than 4. In this case, we multiplied 4 by a fraction and got a number that is less than 4. Why did we get a different result in these two situations? You probably see the answer already. It depends on the size of the fraction. In the first example, we multiplied by a fraction greater than 1, and the answer was greater than 4. In the second example, we multiplied by a fraction less than 1, and the answer was less than 4. Here's one last situation. What if we multiplied by a fraction that is equal to 1? Here, we show 4 multiplied by the fraction 3/3. 3/3, of course, is equal to 1 whole unit. When we multiply, we get 12/3. 12/3 is equal to 4. So, 4 times 3/3 is equal to 4. When we multiplied 4 by a fraction equal to 1, the answer was the same number we started with, 4. So we see that we can have 3 different results when we multiply by a fraction. If we multiply by a fraction that is greater than 1, the answer is greater than the number we started with. If we multiply by a fraction equal to 1, the answer is equal to the number we started with. If we multiply by a fraction less than 1, the answer is less than the number we started with. In the remainder of this lesson, you'll be asked to predict the outcome when a number is multiplied by a fraction. You don't have to do the multiplication, just determine what will happen. Now you try a few. For each question, click on the correct button. In this example, the correct answer is less than. The answer is less than the starting number. The fraction you multiply by is less than 1. So the answer is less than the starting number.